Hey everyone, Patrick CK here with a solution to a problem I recently started experiencing when working on my WordPress sites. I noticed on several different sites, after saving the same page many times, the process of saving was taking longer to complete. It got to the point where, on occasion, it wouldn't save at all. I thought to myself that this can't be a server issue, since I have a beefy dedicated server with plenty of horsepower, RAM, and an optimized OS. So I installed a database optimizing plugin called WP Optimizer on one of the sites that was experiencing the issue and noticed something intriguing. Among the list of items that the plugin looks to optimize and clean up are page revisions. It showed that there were 453 page revisions in the database, which, needless to say, seemed a bit high, considering that the site only had 7 main pages, including the homepage. But after thinking about it for a second, actually I wasn't surprised there were that many page revisions. One reason for this is if you're using, say, Elementor, Beaver Builder, Divi, or really any of the advanced page builders, making quick page updates is so easy that you lose track of how often you actually hit that update button. I mean, when it takes literally 6 seconds to open a front-end editor, update something minor, and save it, it's no wonder there are a ton of saved revisions. So why is this a problem? Well, to answer that, we have to take a little trip into the bowels of a website, into the database and the fundamental tables that make up the WordPress core. Page revisions are saved in the page or post metadata, in a table called post_meta. The more revisions you save, the larger this table gets. In the site I mentioned with 453 saved revisions, this single table grew to over 246 megabytes. Just for comparison, this table on a completed site with 12 pages, around 30 posts, that doesn't use an advanced page builder, is only 24 megabytes. A significant difference. MySQL database tables simply should not be that big, because it introduces a host of issues. One of those issues is the one I introduced at the beginning. Saving pages with a ton of revisions can take longer to process after an update. Another issue comes when you are trying to deploy a development site, which I personally ran into when trying to update the URLs to the live domain. My search and replace kept hanging when it hit that post meta table. So how do we fix this? One obvious solution is just to use the WP Optimize plugin to flush out all the revisions every once in a while. But this has a couple drawbacks. Mainly, it's a manual process, and when you have multiple people working on a site, it can get out of hand quickly. Also, you'll be wiping out all the revisions, which someone may need. So we need a solution that is automated and keep some revisions available for users who may need them. Luckily, there is an incredibly simple solution that only takes one line of code to implement. And deep in the WordPress development documentation, there is a little piece of code that limits the number of revisions saved to a specified amount. By default, WordPress will save unlimited page revisions. This code accomplishes exactly what I wanted. And here it is. Yep, that's it. And it goes straight into your WP config file. Simply swap out the X for the number of page revisions you want to save, or set it to 0 to save no revisions at all. For me, I set it to 12. I feel it's a good balance between having some revisions to work with without going overboard. One peculiar thing about this code is that it only seems to work when added near the top of the WP config file. If you add it at the bottom, it doesn't work for whatever reason. Another thing to take into account is that simply adding the code to an existing site will not remove old revisions. You will still need to run the WP Optimize operation to flush out all the saved revisions to decrease the size of the database. If you don't have access to your WP config file, there is just a simple solution that can be added to your functions.php file. I prefer the former method though, for several reasons, but mainly because your functions.php file is tied to your theme. If you change your theme and forget to add the code, you'll go back to saving all your revisions again. Whichever way you go, it makes a world of difference, especially if you are tasked with website and server maintenance, like myself. After implementing the code, the post-meta table stabilized around 54 megabytes without adding any new pages or posts. A much better situation than before. The saving process was also resolved on every site where I flushed the revisions and then implemented the code. And it hasn't been a problem since I standardized the code for every new development site I create. You can find the pieces of code on my website at the link in the description. I hope this small tip helps you out with your website development. And if you found this video helpful, please leave a like, consider subscribing to get future videos. And until next time, this has been Patrick CK. Goodbye.